And finally, the last of the famous Walker sisters in the Great Smoky Mountains died 55 years ago, but their story still fascinates visitors in the Smokies.
10 News reporter Jim Matheny wraps up our three-part series with a look at how their legacy lives on.
They could have improved their lifestyle. They chose to live the way they lived.
Robin Goddard says it's easy to get the wrong impression about the Walker sisters if you only look at old photos or the remote cabin they left behind when the last sister in the park died in 1964.
They were very knowledgeable of what was going on in the world. They were very smart, and they loved people.
Above all, they loved their home. And the park had to decide what to do with it after the last sister died.
They hoped that the park would take care of it.
So in the 1970s, the park preserved some of these old buildings, including the main house, where you can still walk from the kitchen to the porch to the one other downstairs room, plus a ladder up to the second story that is far from a penthouse. But the buildings are not the only thing saved from the Walker sisters.
Great Smoky Mountains Association funded the purchase of artifacts that belonged to the Walker sisters, some 4,000 items.
Those items are preserved in a temperature-controlled archives building in Townsend, with everything from the sisters' clothes to handmade baskets.
Oh, they're all just spectacular. It's amazing to see this collection. They also made these tiny baskets that they would sell as souvenirs.
Valerie Polk works as a videographer for the nonprofit Great Smoky Mountains Association. But her story is interwoven with the Walker legacy in another way.
My great-grandmother is over here. Caroline Walker Shelton, the only one of John Walker's daughters who married.
And the man Caroline developed a relationship with, Jim Shelton, developed some of the best early photographs of the Walker sisters and the Smoky Mountains in general.
How fortunate are we that he had a camera, that he found that as a hobby that he wanted to do. I come across pictures that he had taken, and it's really touching. The hollow chestnut tree shows my grandmother, both of her sisters, and her brother and her mother. I have lots of cousins out there who are also related to the Walker sisters.
The sisters' legacy lives on in photographs, relatives, and old buildings, and the buildings are preserved better than most.
One of the nice things about going to the Walker sisters' cabin is that it takes some effort to get there. So those people who are willing to make that trip generally are people who will appreciate it more and not do damage to the structures.
While this remote location may mean less vandalism, it may also give the false impression they were isolated. This hiking trail used to be a normal road. Anyone could easily drive to see the ladies who lived in the park.
They delivered right to the front door, and if the mailman delivered and brought it in the house for them, they got a fried apple pie.
They were probably often surrounded by family, and of course, surrounded by the visitors that came to see them from all over. Now I've been able to take my own daughter back there, and it's been a really special thing to see the cabin preserved and to know that artifacts are here in the collection. To go to Ware's Valley and see their graves and see the headstones that all say sister on them and know that my great-grandfather is buried in that same area, it's really special.
But make no mistake, the Walker sisters were different and wrote a story that still captivates millions of people who visit the Smokies every year. A different kind of devotion to their land and to each other, and worth the effort to see for yourself, as long as it makes the right impression.
They were a part of living history here to a lot of people.
If you portray them as stern, old mountain women, that's not right. I think it's important because it's part of the history of the development of this national park. Their life will be preserved forever, as long as there's somebody that will tell the story.
In the Great Smoky Mountains, Jim Matheny, WBIR 10 News.
We're so glad Jim told their story. Jim Matheny did take pictures from the same angle as some of the old photographs of Little Greenbrier and the Walker sisters' cabin, and made these slider tools that you can move to compare to view back then and compare it to today. Go around and play with it at WBIR.com.
It's a really creative tool, and yeah. We appreciate those stories, and thank you for watching. Todd, before we leave,